Spiders, snakes and flying bats, we're out with the creatures of the dark as we take the kids on a night walk right here on Drone and Phone.
Well, welcome to the fourth episode of Drone and Phone Summer Kids Adventures. Where are we today and what are we doing, Alyssa?
Night walk.
We're doing night walking. This is something you can do pretty well anywhere in
Hong
Kong.
Yeah, that means going in the night.
Means torches. Going in the night with torches. What are we going to try and find?
Dangerous animals!
Okay, we're hoping to find some snakes and some wild boar and all sorts of other things. So let's go, guys, let's go!
Yay!
As the summer holidays kick in, finding things to do with the kids can be a challenge in Hong Kong. It's hot and often wet, but there are still activities you can do outside that will keep the children out in the fresh air. For this series, Alyssa, Austin and I have picked five of our favourite summer outdoor adventures. For this episode, we're on Lamma Island for a night walk through the jungle. Lamma has plenty of snakes that come out at night, as well as wild boar that can suddenly appear from the bushes as you startle them. You don't have to be on Lamma Island to enjoy this activity, as it can be done from almost anywhere on a summer night in Hong Kong.
Well, one of the things I love about Hong Kong is wherever you live, you can normally find a bit of jungle fairly close to where you live and get out and explore it at night when it's a little bit cooler and all the animals come out. The summer is definitely the best for this. Now, one tip is to try and find a concrete path and follow that path just to ensure that you can see where you're going and make sure you're out in front to protect the kids who are out discovering stuff. You also get to see things first as well, which is nice. We are going to go off the concrete a little bit on this hike, but now we've got a long piece of concrete that goes right through the jungle with no lights and no people. Let's go.
As the lights go down, many nocturnal creatures come out. We started with spotting lots of spiders that line the paths and reflect in the torchlights. If it is wet after the rains, as it is for us, expect to see lots of frogs, possibly snakes, hunting those frogs.
So this is likely where we're going to find the snakes in these drains
you
down here. So we'll keep looking as we go. Can someone keep checking the drain? See if you can find a snake in there.
Not me!
As well as the more common wild boar, look up the tree for masked palm civets, feeding in the fruit trees, and possibly an East Asia porcupine. Our first decent-sized mammal was a large bat that made circles around us.
Well, we're just stopping here because we've seen a bat flying around this area, quite a big bat that's flying around us. I don't think it's going to be possible to catch it on camera. George is trying right now, but it'd be great if we can. But it literally nearly flew straight into our faces, right, guys?
After 2 kilometres along the concrete paths, it was time to go off-piste through an off-the-beat trail. Trying not to disturb the spiders along the way, we tread carefully through the forest, trying to avoid the notorious poisonous bamboo pit viper.
Well, that's the end of this episode. We didn't see anything huge, but lots of little creepy crawlies and a little bit scary at night. How was it for you, Alyssa?
Okay. A bit tiring.
What about you, Austin?
A little bit
crazy.
I'm so scared.
Are you scared? What about you?
Boring. I didn't do my math homework. Okay.
I enjoyed it.
You'd enjoyed it. Now, as always, please like and subscribe wherever you see this. For now, my name's DJ.
My name's Alyssa.
My name's Pizzeria.
My name is Victoria.
And this is Drone and Phone.